What is good, guys? We with PokerTCG Gamer versus Altama home for Smoke on Snake Draft. So looking at the teams, we can already tell both Midjourners have to be Assault West because both teams are super weak to opposing Shifkey Midjourner. And then I assume this is a Z-move Bulu, and then he can afford to run a Scarf Lando on this team, but I don't know 100% guarantee that it's Scarf Lando, but I can definitely see this being Scarf Lando. But that would mean that it has to be Scarf Rocks Lando. This could be like a 3 attack setup with Roost, because this might only be the defog, but it might also be double defog. But I think this is a 3 attack Roost. And yeah, looking at Tamahome's team, it's looking like a team that is on the forums. And it has, the team on the forums has Specs Coco, Z-move Kyurem. That's like a nice core. Yeah, it could also be LOKB, but like, I don't really see another. Like, I think the Ladi has to be Scarf on this team. So like, I don't really see another Z-move user, because this has to be AV, this has to be Defensive Rocks. This is either Bandit or Mega. So we do see that this is Scarf Lando, because the Intimidate goes up before the Electric Surge. So PokerTCG Gamer will most likely go for U-turn here, because even if Tamahome stays in, he has checks in the back to this Coco. But I can see Tamahome making the aggressive play, because if PokerTCG Gamer here goes for Earthquake, and Tamahome switches into his Landris, he loses all his momentum pretty much. And yeah, exactly. So he goes for U-turn. Tamahome predicts that. I assume he went for either a T-Bolt predicting the Midjourner, or like a Desenthema HP Ice predicting the Bulu. As there's the Bulu. He goes for Desenthema, that is definitely Specs, and that is 68%. So now he's forced out into his Midjourner here. If I was Rob, I mean, he could stay in here predicting Tamahome to double, because like, he has played aggressive turn 1, so he might play aggressive again, so staying in here would be a nice play. So predicting Midjourner, he might go into either his... He doesn't really have the best play to Midjourner. I assume he's gonna go to his own Midjourner. Yeah, I assume he's gonna go to his own Midjourner. And Rob is either gonna predict him to switch or go to his Midjourner as well. Yeah, so that's the Midjourner from both sides. Like I said, both have to be assault with. So Rob goes for Volt Switch, and he either wins a speed dive there, or Tamahome has less speed IVs. A lot of the time you want to have as little speed on your Midjourner as possible, because you want to be slower than stuff like Celesteela, because if Celesteela leech sheets your assault with Midjourner, you want to get a slow Volt Switch out of there, which is amazing in some scenarios. And also with opposing AV Midjourner, slow Volt Switch is super nice. I assume Tamahome either went for Volt Switch or Iron Head. What is he gonna go to here? Maybe Zapdos, because Mantine is too risky on a Volt Switch, Lando is too risky on a potential. Like, if Tamahome predicted that, like, if he knows that his Midjourner has like little speed, then he would know that PokerTCG's Midjourner might be faster, and then he could predict him to Volt out slower. And he can definitely go for like a Floor Cannon or like an Ice Beam predicting a Switch. So this is a tough turn. He's either, I think, go Zapdos or like sack the Bulu. Bulu is not doing much at this point. Can potentially get his health back with Hornleech versus Lando or Tita, but other than that, it's not doing much. So he just went for Iron Head, knowing that there's opposing Midjourner's AV, and Iron Head will do some nice damage. And yeah, why can I not talk? Rob, I should call him Rob, this name is way too long. I'm gonna call him Rob now. Rob sacks off his Bulu, and assume he's gonna go back to his Midjourner, or he's gonna... Yeah, either back to Midjourner or to Lando, like he doesn't have many options, yeah. So now he has to spam Iron Head, because... unless he has Hidden Power Fire, yeah, he doesn't have anything to touch this. He gets a flinch there. But yeah, now Tamahome sees he only has Iron Head to hit this. So Tamahome might switch... If he's Helmet Landorus, he could go into his Landorus here to get some chip on this, and Grassy Terrain would end the next turn. But he could also stay in and try to get a slow Volt Switch out again. Because like, this Midjourner has been faster 2 times now than the opposing Midjourner, so I'm pretty sure at this point that this Midjourner is slower, it's not a speed tie, most likely. So he goes on the Landorus, anticipating another Iron Head. That's a fire play from Rob, going for a Floor Cannon. And yeah, I assume he's gonna go for Rocks here, since this is at -2, this Midjourner cannot do much to him. I mean, Flurkin will not kill at -2. So I assume we're gonna see one of these 3 mons coming out here. Either Zapdos to keep the hazards off, But the thing is, if he goes to Zapdos to keep the health off, that gives the Kyurem a switch in, and he doesn't have much to check the Kyurem. He only has the Majorna. So yeah, I assume he's gonna go to his own land or to Zapdos here. But yeah, whenever Tama gets his Kyurem, it's gonna be a problem for Rob. Especially if he has his Landers in and he's locked into a specific move, like, let's say, he's locked into, like, let's say Tama sacks something on a U-turn, and then he would be locked into that, or let's say he goes for rocks, because it's a Scarf Rocks, it's the only rocker, we have already talked about this, because he would be locked into Scarf Rocks, that will also give the Kyurem a free hit on the Majorna, like either HP Fire or a Fusion Bolt. I assume this is, either off power or HP Fire, depends on the Coco. Depends if the Coco is HPS or HP Fire. If the Coco is HP Fire, the Kyurem might have off power instead of HP Fire. But he just goes for rocks here, and this is obviously faster because it's Scarf, so HPI threatens this out. So Tama can either go hard in the Kyurem here. He has a few options here. He can stay in, predicting him to not go for HPIs and go for a slow U-turn. Or he can go hard to Kyurem. Like, I don't think he necessarily needs the Lando at this point, but yeah, hard to Kyurem is a completely fine play. And now he goes for Scarf Rocks. He's locked in. This means he doesn't have to go for Ice Beam. He can go for the best move that he has to hit the Majorna. So this is Sub-Zero Slammer Kyurem. So he can either go for Fusion Bolt, Off Power, HP Fire, whatever he chooses or whatever he has that does the most to the Majorna. Since it's AV Majorna, I assume Fusion Bolt will do probably the most, depending on the Kyurem spread. Most of the time, Z-Move Kyurem runs max attack and not that much in special attack. So Off Power, HP Fire might even do less than Fusion Bolt, so he's probably just gonna Fusion Bolt. It hits everything decently hard. With Rocks Up, it should do around like a bit over 40 to the Majorna. And it might even kill a Fusion Bolt into Z Sub-Zero Slammer might even kill the Majorna. So there's the Majorna. He was kind of forced to go into that. Takes 36 plus rocks. And Sub-Zero Slammer, I'm pretty sure, kills from here, yeah. Like, it's like 200 base power and it's like stab and it's... Kyurem is strong as fuck. I don't have to explain this to you guys, right? You all know how strong Kyurem Black is. Like, if Kyurem Black got a good physical stab, like, that's what Z Icicle, not Icicle Crush, Z Freeze Shock basically gives it what Kyurem ever always wanted in Gen 6 or in Gen... I don't know about Gen 5 because I didn't play Gen 5, but in Gen 6 it wanted like a physical ice stab and didn't have it. I mean, it's like a one-time nuke, but you can also use it sometimes. I recorded a live. Was it like a Venusaur? You can also sometimes go for Freeze Shock. If they like the predicting, they go for like a Synthesis. If you already wasted your Z-move, then they think they will wall you potentially. But yeah, I think he's just gonna fire off the Z-move because this kind of just gets a kill. Like, there's nothing to do about, like, Rob can't do anything about it. It just gets a kill. So, not sure if Rob predicted the double there. I think he was knowing that the Z-move was gonna come out there and he just had to pick his fodder. And Zapdos wasn't gonna do that much because they have the T-Tar. And the Coco also beats the Zapdos. Yeah. And, like, Ladi also beats Zapdos. Like, Zapdos wasn't gonna do much in this game. Like, Ladi can potentially trick it, or, yeah, like, basically, Zapdos wasn't gonna do much. I don't know why I'm, like, repeating myself. But, yeah, he was forced to go for Floor Cannon there. To be fair, yeah, that was a fine play by Tamahome, because he didn't need the Kyurem anymore. Now he can go to Coco, and if Dazzling Gleam kills, he can click Dazzling Gleam, but I assume it might not kill, since most Majornas run, like, max with AV these days. And they take a bit out of HP, they only run like 200 HP and they put like 56 in special attack. I think that is to Oko Zygarde always. I'm not 100% sure what the special attack was for. I think it was to Oko Zygarde. But yeah, it depends on if he has HP Ice or HP Fire. If he has HP Fire, that's also another option. As we do see, that is HP Fire. So that's definitely cool for stuff like Ferrothorn to weaken Ferrothorn for his Kyurem. And then he doesn't even... Maybe sometimes he doesn't even have to use his Z-move to kill Ferrothorn with Kyurem. Like, HP Fire in general is really amazing for Tama's team to weaken Ferrothorn, for Ladi, and for Kyurem, for the two dragons. Yeah, just weaken Steel types. Like, it obviously doesn't weaken Heatran, but for Heatran you have Specs T-Bolt. And yeah, for Celesteela also you have Specs T-Bolt. Celesteela is not... Yeah, Celesteela gets dicked by this team because you have slow Majorna with slow Volt Switch, you have Specs Coco, probably a Bantar, it's not revealed yet. Could still be Mega. And then you have Kyurem, which also destroys it if Terrain is up with Fusion Bolt or with Sub-Zero Slammer. So he goes Greninja. I assume he's gonna go for a Hydro Pump or a Gunk Shot. Probably a Hydro Pump. Oh, he doubles out, okay. But this doesn't work out for him. This doesn't work out for him because the Ladi is most likely Scarf, and I think Draco kills offensive Lando after rocks. It might be a roll. So Mantan can eat this up, but now Mantan is forced to roost, and that gives him a free switch into Titar or Coco. And then he can pretty much get a kill if he breaks correct. Yeah, Titar is the better play because it kind of has no switch-ins, and Coco, like, Coco you still have to predict. If you go for a Dazzling Gleam predicting Lando and he stays in, then you don't beat him. But if Titar, you kind of just destroy something. So he can Stone Edge or... I don't know if he's gonna have the rare Ice Punch to hit Landorus. Let's see. Oh, will he Mega Evolve or is he Bandit? That's my main question here. He's Mega, so he definitely is gonna have Ice Punch if he's Mega. What the fuck? This guy is Jesus, how? So, like, he was like, let me make the hard read here and go for Ice Punch. This Greninja is, I assume it's Ash. Yeah, he gets this Ash form there, Battle Bond. But now he can go into his either Majorna or Latios. Yeah, he goes Ladi and he clicks Draco here. The game pretty much ends here. I think he needs a dodge at this point. Yeah, he doesn't get it. And okay, there were like a few turns where I guess I could have tried to analyze Rob's plays a bit better, but like the Kyurem was just pretty hard for him to deal with. And like the one time where he Floricaned, like I completely stand, like I would have made the play as well. You had to kill the Kyurem. If you don't kill, like if Kyurem comes back in late, that would be a huge threat. So, like, you can say Tamahoe might have wanted to save Kyurem, but to be fair, like, if you pay attention, you realize that he didn't need a Kyurem to win anymore. He already weakened the Majorna with it, so Specs Coco was gonna destroy, especially after the Lando went down. That was a fire play with the Titar Ice Punch on the Lando.